Lawsuits aside, Jeff Bezos is planning to give SpaceX a run for their money, and it's evident as Jeff recently took off into space in his new Shepard rocket. However, his eyes are set on even something bigger, orbital flights with his new Glenn rocket. But what is the new Glenn rocket? Well, you'll find out in just a second, but before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. On Jeff Bezos' short journey to space, he was accompanied by Mark Bezos, his brother, Wally Funk, an 82-year-old pioneer of the space race and an 18-year-old student. They travelled in a capsule with the biggest windows flown in space, offering stunning views of the Earth. When the capsule touched back down after the 10-minute, 10-second flight, Jeff Bezos exclaimed, "Best day ever." New Shepard, built by Bezos' company Blue Origin, is designed to serve the burgeoning market for space tourism and place it as a close competitor to SpaceX Falcon spacecraft to gain the edge in NASA aid contracts for development. On this flight was the oldest person who has been to space, Miss Funk, and the youngest student, Oliver Damon. The spacecraft lifted off from a private launch site near Van Horn, Texas. At a post-launch news briefing, Jeff Bezos said,
"Oh my God! My expectations were high, and they were dramatically exceeded."
2 minutes into the flight, the capsule separated from its rocket and continued upwards towards the Kármán line, the most widely recognized boundary of space that lies 100 kilometers up. Jeff Bezos recently resigned as chief executive of Amazon, the e-commerce giant he founded, in order to concentrate on his other ventures, including Blue Origin. So you can understand how serious he is about his dreams of building highly capable spaceships. However, there are a few issues with the spaceship project of his next in line for completion, the new Glenn. In the fall of 2017, shortly after he became chief executive officer of Blue Origin, Bob Smith received an extensive briefing on the state of the new Glenn rocket program. The projected launch date for the massive reusable rocket was 2020, he was told. As Smith assessed the progress on new Glenn to date and drew upon his long experience at Honeywell Aerospace, he soon came to the conclusion that this launch date was unreasonable. "This is not a 2020 launch program," he said at this meeting. "This is a 2022 program at best." Jeff Bezos was not present for this, but his response afterwards was that he would absolutely not accept any revision to the launch date for the large orbital rocket. "Blue Origin should be optimistic with its projections," Bezos said, "and then they should meet those projections." Bezos' rocket company, of course, did not meet those projections. Not only did New Glenn not launch in 2020, last week Blue Origin said it would not launch until the fourth quarter of 2022 at the earliest. As part of its announcement, Blue Origin also did not take much blame for the rocket's delay. Instead, the company blamed the delay mostly on a potential customer, the US Department of Defense. Blue Origin's New Glenn project is incredibly ambitious. If successfully developed, it would offer a revolutionary heavy lift service to low Earth orbit, geostationary space, and even the moon. So what really has gone wrong? As part of his overall space strategy, Bezos has been thinking about building a large reusable orbital rocket for a long time. Step one was to learn how to reuse rockets with the much smaller New Shepard launch system, which consists of a single engine booster and capsule. And the company's engineers have over the last 5 years, New Shepard successfully completed more than a dozen suborbital missions with picture-perfect rocket landings. But long before New Shepard took its first flight, Bezos was already deep into planning his next rocket. During a meeting in December 2011 with then-NASA Deputy Administrator Lori Garver, Bezos discussed an orbital rocket capable of challenging SpaceX's Falcon 9 booster. The big rocket at the time, which would become known publicly as New Glenn more than half a decade later, was not quite so big as New Glenn is envisioned today. Rather than being powered by 7 BE-4 engines and towering nearly as tall as NASA's Saturn V rocket, Bezos originally envisioned a more modest-sized rocket comparable to the Falcon 9 or United Launch Alliance's Delta IV. In some iterations, New Glenn had just 3 main engines. This would have represented a more incremental step for a launch company that has yet to put a gram of material into orbit. But instead of offering a waypoint between New Shepard and a massive orbital rocket, Bezos ultimately opted to jump right to the massive 313-foot-tall version. Bezos asked his engineering team to begin sprinting towards the launch pad. The engineering challenges of building such a large rocket are big enough. But because New Glenn is so expensive to build, the company needs to recover it from the outset. SpaceX enjoyed a learning curve with the Falcon 9, only successfully recovering the first stage on the rocket's 20th launch. Blue Origin engineers will be expected to bring New Glenn back safely on its very first mission. The demands placed on Blue Origin's engineers were thus clearly very heavy. Blue Origin is now juggling a number of other major projects in addition to New Glenn. There is the ongoing effort to put humans onto suborbital New Shepard flights, which may happen as soon as late spring or early summer. This has been a long slog, as Bezos once suggested humans may fly on the suborbital launch system as early as 2017. There is work on the BE-4 engine itself, which will ultimately power New Glenn. As part of its development process, Blue Origin engineers pushed through a lot of technical issues with the engine's turbo pump system. Technicians and engineers are working hard to deliver flight-ready BE-4 rocket engines to United Launch Alliance, an important customer, by this summer. This is probably Blue Origin's most immediate priority. Blue Origin is also leading the national team, which includes industry heavyweights such as Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman, that seeks to build a lander for human missions to the moon. This is a heated, high-profile competition with two other bidders, SpaceX and a Dynetics-led team, and the prize is billions of dollars in contracts and enormous prestige in carrying astronauts down to the surface of the moon. NASA is expected to pick one or two finalists in April to move forward. Bezos desperately wants to prevail here and gain the contract, snubbing SpaceX. Clearly, for now, New Glenn has taken a back seat. The vehicle's delayed to the fourth quarter of 2022, and let's be honest, that means at least 2023, comes down to a combination of two things. First, there is the enormity of the engineering challenge, which is due to Bezos' decision to opt for a larger New Glenn design. Secondly, Blue Origin simply has higher priorities right now. Nevertheless, Blue Origin expects each New Glenn rocket will be capable of launching and landing 25 times. The rocket would be larger than any other vehicle flying currently, and the company says it has invested $2.5 billion in New Glenn's development. New Glenn stands about 320 feet tall and is designed to lift about 45,000 kilograms of payload to low Earth orbit. Blue Origin has built a mock-up of the booster stage of New Glenn to run tests ahead of the first launch from Florida, and has invested heavily in manufacturing and testing facilities at Cape Canaveral, with about 1 million square feet of real estate. The company noted that, of the $2.5 billion invested in New Glenn, about $1 billion was spent to rebuild the LC-36 launch pad. Blue Origin's work at LC-36 includes building a tower that can support launching people on New Glenn, which the company hopes to do later. Bezos personally funds Blue Origin's development by selling part of his Amazon stock. While he has said that he sells about $1 billion of Amazon shares annually to fund the space company, Bezos has recently increased his sales of Amazon stock, cashing out more than $10 billion worth in 2020. Bezos' vision is compelling. Without a doubt, we can say that if New Glenn is completed, it'd be a fantastic competitor to SpaceX. Rapid advances in aerospace technology will come out if there's neck-to-neck competition, and Bezos' efforts are going to lead to that. So, what do you think? Do you think New Glenn will be able to compete, or will Jeff Bezos have to experience another failure this late in his successful life of entrepreneurship? If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. See you there!